Hello, today we're in the Polygon Samurai Empire pack, and I'm going to be showing you a couple of things about setting up and using the Unity terrains. First of all, a couple of troubleshooting tips. If your terrain is shiny like you see here, then what you need to do is go to the base texture and change the compression from high quality to normal quality. And if you've opened up Unity 6 and you've got this shadowy bug when you try to paint textures, one of the things you can try to do is go to your project settings and change from DX12 to DX11. As for setting up the terrain itself, what you want to do is create a 3D object terrain and go to the terrain settings and change the scale a lot lower because it's quite big by default, especially the height. Then what I like to do is to change the terrain height because by default it is at its lowest point. So what you want to do is raise it a little bit and then set height. You can shift click to get a sample of what height you want and then just cover the whole terrain. Then as you can see here, you can raise the terrain up and also dig down. This is also now a good opportunity to test your maximum height and depth and tweak as necessary. Next, we need to add some terrain textures. So we're going to, in your project window, create a terrain layer. Create a grass, for example. And then just select the texture and the normal map. And then we're going to come back to the terrain settings and add a new terrain layer. Add any extra layers that you might need. And you can use the brushes tab to change how the tool paints onto the terrain. Here I've grabbed a couple of buildings from the demo scene, and as you can see, painting on a few different layers of different textures really helps set it into the scene. You can very quickly improve the look by adding in some ground prefabs like rocks and gravels and tiles to add that 3D element that really sells it as part of the world. For trees, you can either manually place the prefabs, or you can go to the tree tab and add the prefabs and use the terrain tools to quickly paint them in at different scales and rotations. For grass, you can either use the same technique if you have prefabs. In this case, I'm using a grass texture and using the built-in Unity terrain grass system. It's best to paint a patch of grass first and then modify it from there before continuing to dress the rest of the scene. You can also add them as a detail mesh, but it does not support LOD groups, so it can be a little heavier. For our maps, we do manually place all of our prefabs just to make sure it is in the exact spot that we want it to be. But if you are making a bigger scene, it makes sense to use some tools to help speed up the process. Final step to improve the look is to add some camera post effects. If you're using the Universal Render Pipeline, you need to add a global volume to your scene. And from there, you can add overrides. And I'd recommend a baseline of bloom, color adjustments, vignette, and lift gamma gain. That's all for today. I hope you have found this video helpful, and good luck with your world creation.